del mundo. Y Venezuela tiene la primera reserva de petróleo que país alguno tenga en el mundo. Esa es la razón fundamental del desespero de Mr. Danger.
This is a dangerous enemy to our sun, controlling a huge pool of oil that could hurt us very badly.
Ellos quieren el petróleo venezolano y el gas venezolano. Lo tuvieron durante 100 años, lo hemos recuperado y ahora ese petróleo es para el desarrollo de nuestro pueblo y para el desarrollo de los pueblos más pobres de este continente. Venezuela no más nunca será colonia de los Estados Unidos de Norteamérica.
Beautiful Venezuela.
Estamos avanzando a paso firme hacia la integración, hacia un nuevo nivel de integración en América Latina, en el Caribe.
Who along with Cuba leads the way in bringing light and hope to the world.
We will continue to fight against the actions of our own government.
Cuba, Venezuela. Entre Cuba y Venezuela hemos logrado
drive separation between Cuba, Venezuela, and the people of the world.
So here you have an extremely rich country, enormous wealth, highly concentrated, most of the population living in near misery. And finally there's a government that's actually doing something for them. They can like him or hate him, but his policies happen to be that they've got the first government in the history of the country that's actually doing something.
We have the ability to take him out, and I think the time has come that we exercise that ability.
Beautiful Venezuela.
We don't need another $200 billion war to get rid of one, strong-arm dictator.
Who withstood the efforts by the CIA to overthrow this legitimate government?
You know, I don't know about this doctrine of assassination, but if he thinks we're trying to assassinate him, I think we really ought to go ahead and do it.
Beautiful Venezuela.
And I don't think any oil shipments will stop.
Who, along with Cuba?
This is in our sphere of influence, and we can't let this happen.
Form the axis of good.
Rather than returning to Canada, our passion for Cuba and its complex history has brought us to South America. We wanted to get some answers on the criticized relationship of Fidel Castro and Hugo Chavez. We decided to continue our journey to the country of the supposed strong-armed dictator in Venezuela. We had many unanswered questions about this criticized relationship, and because we couldn't get the interview we had tried to get in Cuba, we would instead try to find President Hugo Chavez on our own. We would also try and see if Chavez is actually the threat the United States makes him out to be.